Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be walking through a centered difference method example. The centered difference method is a numerical technique commonly used to approximate derivatives of a function. It's a simple yet effective numerical technique that can be applied to various scenarios. If you missed our past video on the theory behind the centered difference method, I will leave a link in the description down below for you to check out. After that video, you should have a strong understanding of how this method works, how to use it, and why we learn about it. Let's get to our first problem now. We are given the function f of x equals x squared. We are asked to approximate the derivative of this function at x equals 2 using the centered difference method. We are also told to use a step size of 0.05. Let's begin by graphing our given function and then writing out the formula for the centered difference method that we developed in the last video. We say that the derivative of some point is approximately equal to the function evaluated at a step size ahead minus a step size behind our center point, over 2 times our step size. Now, all we need to do is some evaluations of our function. Let's evaluate our function of x squared at 2.05 and 1.95. Now, plugging in all our required variables, we receive that the derivative is approximately equal to 4. Which we can see analytically is the exact solution to our problem. This is a good example of the centered difference method providing less error than both the forward and backwards difference method, which we found in previous videos. Next, let's complete a more challenging problem. In this example, we are asked to use the forward difference method to find the derivative of e to the x times sine x over x for an input of 0.5 and a step size of 0.05. Well, although this function may have not been fun to solve analytically in the past, let's note how easy and quick it is to find the derivative with numerical differentiation. So, we'll just evaluate our function at 0.45 and 0.55, just like we did before. Now, we can plug these values into our centered difference equation, and we find that the derivative at 0.5 of this function is approximately 1.3128. Which is extremely close to our analytical solution, as you can see here. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to solve a problem using the centered difference method. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.